Welcome students. In previous class, we have studied about how to locate ICR for various configurations or various cases such as one link mechanism, two link mechanism, three link mechanism and cylinder between two parallel plates moving in the same direction and in opposite direction. We have also seen to find out the distances from ICR to that particular point. The thing which will help us is the sine rule and the cosine rule. So till here we have studied in the previous class. Now let us apply this all logics and concepts in the problems given. Let us start with the first problem, which says a ladder AB of length L equal to 4.8 meters rests on an horizontal floor at point A and leans against the vertical wall at B. If the lower end A is pulled away from the wall with a constant velocity of 3 meter per second, what is the angular velocity of the ladder at that instant when A is 2.4 meter from the wall? This question was asked in December 2019 paper as far as Mumbai University is concerned. So this is the diagram given wherein you can see that there is a ladder of 4.8 meters leaning against the wall having the velocity of 3 meter per second towards right side at point A. The distance of point A from the wall is 2.4 meters as shown in this diagram. Now let us start with the solution. The first step in any problem of kinematics of rigid bodies will be to locate ICR. To locate ICR, we have a simple concept that we have to draw the perpendicular from all the points on the body and wherever they meet, that will be your ICR. So let us start with that. Now, as it is given that this point A is shifting towards right hand side, that means its velocity will be in this direction, which is already given. Now, as this point A moves towards right side, this B will try to come down. That means its velocity will be in this direction. Let us say it is VB. Now, as we know the direction of velocities from both the points, now next step is what? Next step is to draw the perpendicular to the velocities. So let us start with this point. This point A moving towards right side horizontally, hence perpendicular will be drawn like this. So this is perpendicular to this velocity. Similarly, from point B, the velocity at point B is vertical towards downside. So the perpendicular will be like this. So this line is perpendicular to this velocity. So what we have done, we have just drawn the perpendiculars from the velocity of each point on that particular link. What we found that these velocities are intersecting at this particular point. Hence, I will name this point as my ICR or I. Hope you have understood this. It's very simple logic. Just draw perpendiculars to the velocities at each point on the link. And wherever they meet, that will be your ICR. Now let us proceed further. So after first step of locating ICR, which is this point, now I will tell you about the simple method about how to proceed in the problems of kinematics of rigid bodies. First, what you need to do is first write the name of ICR. So let us say I'm writing here ICR is I, because there is only one body, there will be only one ICR, that is I. Next step, you write what are the different points on the bodies. So the different points are point A and point B. So I will write here point A and point B. What is next? Next, we have to write the formula V is equal to R omega. That's it. So I will write V is equal to, or VA, because I am writing it for point A, I will write VA is equal to RIA. This is the important part. Why RIA? Because we have seen in our previous lectures This R is the distance from ICR to that particular point. So my ICR is I and this is my point which is under consideration. So the distance from this point to this point is IA. Hence I have written RIA multiplied by omega AB. Why AB? Because this link, because this point AB lies on link AB. There is only one link. So I will write omega AB. Similarly, I will write down formula for B. So what I will get? I will get VB is equal to, because it is point B, RIB. Why RIB? Because I want distance from I 2b, so it is ib multiplied by, again as the point b is on ab, I will write omega ab. So this is the step which you need to write down in any problem of ICR or kinematics of rigid bodies. Now next step. Next step is to find out these values. What is the distance of RIA and RIB? When you find out these distances, the solution will follow automatically. So for RIA and RIB, in any problem, after writing down this formula, find out all the distances which are required. Okay, again I repeat, first step, you write the ICR number or what is ICR. So I have written here ICR 1. Then write what are the points that is belonging to that ICR. So it is point A and B. And third step, you write the formulas for velocities at that particular points. Fourth step will be to find out the distances. To first find out all the distances and then we can proceed further. So now I need the distance RIA and RIB. So let us consider this triangle IAB. This triangle IAB. In this triangle, the distance IB is already known to us. How? Because we are given that this point A is at a distance of 2.4 meters from the wall. So if this is 2.4, this distance, so I can write down same, because it is a rectangle, I can write down this is also 2.4 meters. Okay, so I got the answer for this I1B. Next is find out distance of RIA. Now you can see in this triangle BIA, this side is making 90 degrees. That means it is a right angle triangle. And in a right angle triangle, I know this side, that is 4.8 hypotenuse. I know one of that side, that is 2.4. So I can easily find out this side by using Pythagoras theorem. So I will apply Pythagoras theorem and I will get answer as IA is equal to 4.156 meters. Okay, so I got answer of IA, I got answer of IB. Now put these values in the above equation. So what I will get? See here, in this case, VA is already known to us as 3 meter per second. So in place of VA, I will write 3. In place of RIA, we have already found out 4.156, so I will substitute that. And with this, I will get answer for omega AB. So this is one of the answer, that is omega AB is equal to 0.7248 radian per second. Now, as I got omega AB, now you have to see which equation contains this term. So there is only one equation here and it contains omega AB. So what I will do, I will substitute this value of omega AB in this equation. Okay. Also, I know the value of RB, RIB. So these two values are known. I will substitute it and I will get answer for VB as 1.74 meter per second. This completes the entire solution. So you can see it was a quite simple solution coming for 4 to 6 marks. What are the steps? Locate ICR, write the points, write the formula, find out the lengths, substitute, get the answer. That's it. Again, I repeat, simple steps. First step, locate ICR. Second step, write the points. Third step, write the formula for velocities. Fourth step, find out various lengths. Fifth step, substitution. That's it. So it is as simple as that. And this procedure, which I have showed in this particular problem, I will follow exactly the same way of solving the problem in any problem of kinematics of rigid bodies, so as to maintain uniformity in the solution. In exam also, whatever kind of problem you get, just follow these steps and you will reach to the final answer. That's it. Hope you have understood this problem.